Hello students, welcome to another video lesson in the ICT for grade 7 series. In today's lesson, I am going to talk to you about the features of email. Let us start by looking at the contents of today's lesson. In this video lesson, we will 1. Discuss the features of email. 2. Demonstrate the email features with videos and pictures. We will be using Google Mail to illustrate the features of email. Thirdly, we will have some quick tests, and finally, a recapitulation of the lesson. We will start with a small recap of email, as we will be using this term all along this lesson. So, what is an email? An email is a message sent or received over the internet. To send and receive email, we need an email address, which can be obtained by creating an account with an email provider. 2. A device that can connect to the internet. And thirdly, an email software or a web browser installed on the device. Let us now start by looking at the features of email. The main features are security, the ability to organize messages in folders, and tools to create, send, and receive messages. Sign in. This is a security feature that prevents other people from accessing your account. Sign in is also called log in. To access your email account using a web browser, enter your username, enter your password, and click on Sign In. Watch this small video which demonstrates the Sign In feature. Log in to your Google Mail account. You need to enter your username, followed by the password. After entering your username and password, click on Next. Google Mail starts loading, and here you are. Your account is open. You can read your messages and access your folders. Sign out. Signing out closes the email program, so that if you want to use it again, you will have to enter your username and password once more. Always sign out from your email account when you have finished reading and sending emails. Follow this demonstration showing how to sign out. Click on the icon representing the user, and you have the option to sign out. Once you have signed out, you will have to enter your password again to log in or sign in. Organizing messages. The email program allows messages to be organized in folders. For example, we have a folder for received messages, another folder to keep copies of sent messages, yet another folder for deleted messages. Here is a screenshot of the email folders. You can see the most important ones, such as inbox, sent, draft, thrush, and spam. Let us now examine the function of each folder one by one. Inbox. Inbox is a main folder. All received messages are stored in this folder. Sent. The sent folder stores a copy of all email you send to others. Drafts. The draft folder stores messages that are being composed or not yet sent. When you start composing a message, a copy is automatically saved in the draft folder. Spam. The spam folder is a location for storing unwanted email. Most often, spam mail contains advertisements for services or products. Regularly check your spam folder because an important message may be mistakenly marked as spam. Trash. The trash folder temporarily stores any emails you have deleted. Messages placed in the trash folder will automatically be deleted after some days. Let us now see another feature of the email program, that is creating a new email message. To create a new email, click on the Compose button. The new message window appears. In the to box, type the email address of the recipient. In the subject box, type a subject for your message. Type your message in the area below the subject box. When you have finished typing your message, click on the send button to send the message. This was a quick overview of how to create and send a new message. But email programs allow us to do much more when creating new messages. Watch the next demonstration to learn about the possibilities we have when creating new messages. Once you have logged into your account, click on the Compose button. The new message window appears. You have a box for recipients, a box for subject. Click on the to box to type in the address of the main recipient. The CC command will allow you to send the same message to other recipients. You also have the option to use the BCC. CC stands for carbon copy. Both the main recipient, whose address is in the to box, and the recipients in the CC box can see all the addresses to which the message was sent. Let us see the BCC option. BCC stands for blind carbon copy. When you type an email address in the BCC box. Neither the main recipient nor the BCC recipients can see the addresses in the BCC box. Let us add some recipients in the BCC box. You can also remove recipients from the list by clicking on the small cross after the email address. Now, type a suitable subject for your message. And start typing your main message. As you can see in the message, the sender has attached a map. Let us see how this can be done. An attachment is a computer file sent along with an email message. It can be a document, a picture, a sound clip, or video clip. Click on the paperclip symbol to select a file to attach to the message. Select your file and click on open. The selected file is being attached. The message is now ready to be sent. Click on the send button. You will see a message sending the message. And finally, message successfully sent. You can open the sent folder to check whether the sent message has been saved. Here we are. The attachment also has been saved. You can also see the list of recipients in the two box, CC box and BCC box. When you are satisfied, do not forget to sign out. So this was a video showing the advanced features when creating and sending a new message. I will now talk to you about reading and deleting messages. Let us start by reading of messages. Reading an email message. To read an email message, sign into your email account. Your inbox folder is displayed. Click on the message you want to read. Once you have signed in to your account, you can see the inbox folder. The number of unread messages is also indicated. Note that unread messages appear in bold. To read an email, just click on it. The message appears on screen. Deleting an email message. There are two ways to delete messages. Option 1, by selecting a message from inbox. Let us see the inbox when no message is selected. As you can see, no message has been selected and there are no icons in the Gmail toolbar. Let us now see what happens when we select a message. As you can see, one message has been selected and icons appear in the Gmail toolbar. And one of the icons is a delete icon. Clicking the delete icon will move the selected message to the trash folder. Let us see a summary of option 1. Tick the checkbox on the left of the message or messages you want to delete. More than one message can be selected. Delete icon appears on Gmail toolbar. Click on delete icon to move message or messages to the trash folder. A delete confirmation message is displayed. And it is possible to undo the delete. There is a second option to delete a message. It is from the read mode. Select a message from the inbox to enter read mode. As you can see, the icons are already there. Among them, the delete icon. Click on the delete icon to move the message to the trash folder. Let us have a summary of option 2. First, select a message from inbox. The message opens in read mode. Number 3, delete icon appears on the Gmail toolbar. Click on delete icon to send the selected message to trash folder. Once again, we get a delete confirmation message and it is also possible to undo the delete. Now let us see how to delete a message from the trash folder. Deleting from trash folder. As you know, deleting a message from inbox moves it to the trash folder. To delete a message forever, click on trash folder to view a list of deleted messages. In this case, we have two messages in the trash folder. Select the message or messages you want to delete forever. And click on delete forever to delete the message. Remember, it is not possible to undo a delete forever action. So these were the features of email. Let us now have some quick tests to check how well you have understood today's lesson. We will have 4 multiple choice questions followed by 4 true false questions. Let us start with the multiple choice questions first. Question 1. The sign-in feature prevents our mail from being A. Infected by viruses, read by other people, deleted by mistake. The answer is B. We saw at the beginning of the lesson that the sign-in feature prevents unauthorized access to your messages. Aye. Question 2. After having used the email program, we must to prevent unauthorized access to our account. A. Sign in. B. Log in. Or C. Sign out. The answer is C. Signing out ensures that the next time you use the email program, you will have to enter the username and password again. Question 3 now. While we are composing a new email, a copy is automatically saved in the folder. A. Draft. B. Inbox. C. Spam. A is the correct answer. Incomplete messages are stored in the draft folder. Let us move on to question 4. Which of the following is not an email folder? A. Spam. B. Trash. Or C. Rejected. The correct answer is C. The rejected folder does not exist in Gmail. Question 5. The spam folder is a location for storing unwanted email. True or false? This is true. The email program automatically detects messages containing advertisements and moves them to the spam folder. Question 6. Every time we send an email message, a copy is saved. True or false? True again. A copy of every sent email is saved in the sent folder. On to question 7. Once we click on delete message, we can never get it back. True or false? This is false, as we can undo the delete or restore the deleted message from the trash folder. Last question. The same email message can be sent to many recipients. Is it true or false? This is true. To send an email to several recipients, we can use a CC or BCC feature. Well done. I am sure you got all the answers correct. Before ending the lesson, we are going to have a recapitulation of what we learned today. We saw that the email program provides account security, such as signing, which prevents unauthorized access to our messages, sign out, which closes the email program, and sign in is required to use the program again. Another email feature is that messages can be organized in folders. Inbox for received messages, sent for messages already sent, draft for messages being composed, trash for deleted messages, and spam for messages irrelevant to us. We have certain tools that we can use when creating messages. CC, that is carbon copy, and BCC, that is blind carbon copy. We can also attach files to the message. Restoring deleted messages. Deleted messages are moved to the trash folder, and they can be restored from the trash folder if needed again. The undo action restores mistakenly deleted messages. But we have to be cautious. Deleting a message already in trash folder deletes it forever. This brings us to the end of today's lesson. I hope you enjoyed it. Until we meet again for another lesson, I wish you plenty of success in your studies. Goodbye.